And good day, everybody. Connor MacIvor, REMAX is Paris 911, we're headquartered in Santa Fe, and we're serving greater Los Angeles. Coming at you this morning, welcoming us back to Blog Talk Radio. We had quite a few people reaching out yesterday. Happy that we actually came back to BTR. We had been on SoundCloud a long time. We're going to still upload the shows there, of course. But again, moving into real estate, those channels, it's better to be more publicized than less. And, you know, to be completely frank with you, I don't think we can get as many listens on SoundCloud as we used to get on Blog Talk Radio. Some of our shows have had over 1,000 listens. Of course, it's kind of busy this morning, a little bit loud, and you'll find that out because I happen to be sitting in Starbucks in a San Diego Sheraton near Harbor Island. So that's where we are this morning. Thought we'd take a few days off and just relax a little bit. So that's what we need. We did do our Monday market update report show this morning, though. That's what I'm doing now. You can find that by very simply going to our main website, paris911.com, and punching in the words market updates into the Mac box in the top part of the screen. When you do, you'll, of course, see this week's reports. We did break them down. We have quite a few, actually. We pulled them for condos, single-family residences, townhomes as well. All the cities in Santa Clarita Valley that are reporting in, you'll be able to see all of those reports. Kind of give you an idea, we are experiencing a flat market still here in Santa Clarita Valley because of our lacking inventory. We do have a huge buyer drive as well, but again, that lacking inventory is really taking its toll. A huge advantage for real estate sellers, though. They're very excited. And of course, they're putting properties on the market for more than they could have ever hoped to have gotten over the past several months. So buyers are going out there, looking at these properties, writing offers, going over asking price. I don't see prices actually declining in the next several months, but I don't see anything in the pace that they've been increasing in price much longer. What's going to happen, I believe, coming up here in the next month or two, we're going to get more and more inventory. Right now, we're around 545, 555 real estate listings for sale that are in the active field. Probably push that up by a couple hundred units, overlapping the current buyer drive, and then we're going to see some relaxation, at least the prices. Not decreases, but relaxation of. So we wanted to throw that out there, too. You know, this week we do have our Travel Tuesdays broadcast. That's going to be tomorrow. We're going to get into some systems that we've built online. A couple of them, you can check those out by going to our, well, any of these websites here. So what we did is for our market reports, we always talk about SCV Reports, scvreports.com. You can go there and get your own market reports for the Santa Clarita Valley City. Kind of cool, actually. We do have the system in place. You'll see a workable map. You'll see the cities that we actually represent. And then you'll be able to go there and get information about any one of those cities. So you'll see graphical data right away. Or if you say, you know what, I want to get this stuff emailed to me every week, then you can enter more information. But at least that way, you'll be able to see all the real estate data as it pertains to each one of the Santa Clarita Valley. And we're talking about Acton, Aqua Dulce. We're talking about New Hall, Saugus, Stevenson Ranch, Cascade, Canyon Country, and Valencia. Did I throw New Hall and Saugus in? I think I did. But you'll be able to get that. We also have a few cities in the San Fernando Valley that are also on the charts that we're active within. So you'll see Northridge. You'll also see Granada Hills. And, of course, that doesn't mean we're just limited to these areas. We get all over Southern California. Lisa Viejo, not too long ago, closed the listing out there. For some friends of ours actually listed and sold a property in Lisa Viejo. Been up to San Jose. Yeah, that was quite a feat. I don't think I'd take one that far again. But, anyway, we have three there. So, you know, you get it. It makes sense. People trust us. It's really hard to break away from the local thing. While there is an advantage to being local, you know, some people don't care, and we always lay it out to everybody. You could get a better advantage potentially, especially with the San Jose properties, by somebody local. They said, you know what, we just want to work with you. You're licensed in the state of California. I said, yes, I am. They said, good enough. We're going to go ahead and just use you, and I'm sure it works out. Well, we had multiple offers in each one of those situations, and it still worked out. A little trickery. You know, we had to get out there. Join the board as an affiliate. A little complicated. I had to hire a local real estate agent out there to do the footwork, and it works. You know, I paid him a little bit, and she actually ended up doing a very, very good job. So we were able to get that done, and at least property sold for the seller that was trusting us to take these listings and put them on the market. So Market Watch Santa Clarita Valley, last 24 hours, excuse me, 7 days. We're going to cover 7-day recap. You can see that again. Punch the words market update into the Mac box at paris911.com. You'll see all that information. 97 new listings, 40 properties have experienced price changes, 41 properties actually coming back on the market, failing to continue in closed escrow. 61 properties entered into the backup offer status, 12 properties expired, 46 properties went pending, 94 properties sold in closed escrow in the last 7 days in Santa Clarita Valley. One of the things to look for whenever you are interested in looking at the real estate data, you want to get this market update report. Again, you can go to scdreports.com, check that out, and of course, realtor.paris911.com, where we put all the real estate data pertaining to the local market. Now, this week in Santa Clarita real estate, as far as Santa Clarita goes proper, prices are definitely tapping out. That level is $549,450, and you can go to, again, punch market updates into the Mac box at paris911.com. We're right around $242 per square foot. That also flattened out. It's taking less time to sell real estate listings in Santa Clarita. That number, 78 days on market, is typical. Percent of properties with a price decrease, 32. Interesting number, because a lot of people, they put their properties on the market, list them for sale, and then they're not moving. Stuff going on out there, so then they reduce that price. Don't be too hasty in reducing your price. I know that your agent's probably going to be frothing at the bit, hoping that you'll reduce that price as low as they can so they can earn a commission. One of the things I would discuss, find out their strategy when they do reduce price. What are you going to be doing with my listing after that? So are we just going to reduce it in the MLS and say good luck? Or are you actually going to relive a lot of the advertising you haven't touched in several months, Mr. and Mrs. Agent? That's a good question. I'm Connor MacIvor. Everybody have a fantastic day. We will talk to you tomorrow. Travel Tuesday's broadcast. We'll get into some of the real estate resources that we put together. And don't forget, if you're looking at Santa Clarita Valley and you're wondering that question everybody asks, does it have Mellow Roos? Well, go to doesithavemellowroos.com. Doesithavemellowroos.com. Be taken very good care of. It is our system. Don't have to panic. We are local real estate agents headquartered in Santa Clarita Valley. I am Connor MacIvor, your host. We do appreciate you. We will talk to you soon. Everybody have a fantastic day.